And the big story coming in from Bengal, huge setback for Mamata Banerjee as Minister Rajiv Banerjee has now resigned from the Mamata cabinet. This is the latest in a slew of revolts, a slew of rebellions that the TMC has been facing. Rajiv Banerjee, the latest in that list to go ahead and resign. No details at this point on his next political move. But the latest TMC minister to go ahead and dump Mamata Banerjee is Rajiv Banerjee. Indrajit is joining us. Poulomi, I beg your pardon, is joining us live from Kolkata with more details on this. Poulomi, what Indrajit was telling us earlier was that this wasn't the offing. He's been speaking out time and again against Mamata Banerjee, against the regime. But why really is this a setback for the TMC? And any details about what exactly Rajiv Banerjee's next political move is?
Well, as Indrajit was in fact pointing out, this was expected for a while right now. And of course, he has of course sent in his resignation to the chief minister and a copy of it to the governor of West Bengal as well. He has in fact resigned from the state cabinet. It remains to be seen whether he goes on to put in his resignation as a member of the TMC as well, and whether he resigns as an MLA as well ahead of the upcoming elections. But like Indra was pointing out, and TMC sources are indicating to us, this was expected, this was in the offing since as late back as 2018, when he was removed as the irrigation minister by the chief minister at that point of time. Currently, he held the forest department. So this is something that was in the offing since he was removed, and the TMC says with good reason. Since then, he had been speaking out time and again against the party. So he was a rebel TMC leader. So this has not come as a surprise for the Trinamool Congress, they say. And sources within the TMC who we've spoken to are indicating and challenging Rajiv Banerjee right now, saying, why don't you contest from your home seat of Dumjur in Howrah from a BJP ticket? Let's see you do that. So clearly the TMC believes that they have very good chances, and Dumjur as a seat belongs to them. So they have in fact challenged Rajiv Banerjee to contest from that very same seat from the Bharatiya Janata Party. But a very interesting development, Akshita, because this comes just a week before Amit Shah is expected to be in Bengal again on the 30th and the 31st of January. And we hear that a lot of people will be joining the Bharatiya Janata Party then in the presence of the Home Minister.
But any news, any information right now, Poulomi, on the BJP perhaps reaching out to Rajiv Banerjee on whether he is joining hands with the BJP?
Well, as of now, we don't have a confirmation on that, but we are trying to seek information from the Bharatiya Janata Party as to whether Rajiv Banerjee is indeed headed the BJP way as far as these elections go. But like I said, it's very interesting that this development has come right before Mr. Amit Shah, in fact, reaches Bengal, and a day before the Prime Minister is here for the Netaji program in Kolkata. This development is something which is quite interesting in that sense. So there is a possibility that Mr. Rajiv Banerjee could be headed the BJP's way, but the TMC, of course, putting up a very brave face,
okay,
not conceding that this is any blow of any sort, saying that we had expected this to happen for months now.
Right, Paul, let me stay with me. I want to take this across to Gaurav Bhatia of the BJP, who's joining us on this broadcast. Gaurav, your reaction to this latest setback for Mamata Banerjee, another minister squid, Rajiv Banerjee this time.
It's a clear reflection that even the erstwhile leaders of the TMC, their ministers, do not have faith in the leadership provided by Mamata Banerjee. And as we have earlier also mentioned, by the time the elections are contested and the results come out, it seems that even Mamata Banerjee's shadow would desert her and she would be left alone. And the reason is very simple. The people of West Bengal are waiting for a change. They want a BJP government. And the politics of corruption, communal politics and dynastic politics that has become symbolic of Mamata Banerjee's politics has been rejected by the people of West Bengal.
Gaurav, there's a lot of speculation of what Rajiv Banerjee is going to do next. The TMC has, in fact, got ahead and issued a dare to him to contest the elections on a BJP ticket. Is the Bharatiya Janata Party going to, in fact, reach out now to Rajiv Banerjee, get him in the fold? There's a lot of speculation because Amit Shah is visiting next week, and we're hearing a lot of TMC leaders, a lot of other party leaders could be joining the BJP.
See, I wouldn't like to comment on that. It would be very premature. But I must say that whether the people of Bengal or the leaders in different political parties, they all get inspired by the leadership that Bharatiya Janata Party provides at the center and even West Bengal. So there is a natural inclination towards the BJP, but this is a decision which our leadership has to take, so I cannot comment on that.
All right, Gaurav, thank you for joining us on this broadcast. So the BJP is saying that this is a reflection of the fact that TMC leaders are now miffed with Mamata, that they're not okay with her leadership. Another minister quitting this time is Rajiv Banerjee. While the TMC says that this was expected, it is no doubt a setback. In the run-up to the elections, this doesn't all go well for the Trinamool Congress.
Hello everyone, this is Rahul Kamal here. Hope you enjoyed this video. For the latest news and analysis, like and subscribe the India Today YouTube channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated.